Hello everyone, not too long ago I finished building my gaming PC, and here it is. I just thought I'd show you guys a video of the finished computer. That's the ASUS 23.6 inch monitor, and then here's the computer itself in the Cooler Master Stormtrooper full tower case. Then let's see in there. We got the power supply, the motherboard, that's the CPU fan, the video card. I got right there my optical drive. The only thing I still need is a SATA data cable that plugs in right where that open spot is. The tower only came with two of them. And I needed three. I thought it would come with a few more than that. So I ordered another one. It's in the mail right now. In the meantime, to install disks and drivers and stuff, I've been using my external DVD reader writer right there by Pioneer. And that's been working just fine. Whoops. Then I got my Seagate 4TB hard drive right there. And a Corsair 256 gig SSD right there. So let me turn this on for you guys. Power button right there. That lights up in red. Little power indicator. I got red fan lights. They come in by default, and then you can turn those on or off by pushing this button right there. So right here, the power supply has a light also, and you can turn that on and off by pushing this. I like leaving them on. It just looks cool. Then that light right there is my card reader. So I'm not going to spend a whole lot of time showing you guys this, but you can see it's all wired and everything. Obviously, I mean, it's running, so let's put this right here. I installed Windows 7 Ultimate for my operating system. And I haven't really done a whole lot to it. As you can see, default background. I haven't downloaded anything. I actually haven't even connected it to the internet yet. I haven't really had a lot of free time. I pretty much just built it, and then it's been sitting here. I've did a few minor things, but nothing major. So, let's see right here. Windows Experience Index rating. The highest is 7.9, the lowest is 1. 7.1 is actually really good. Then I got 8-core processor running at 4 GHz, 64-bit operating system, 16 gigs of RAM. Right here, we have, I don't know. I mean, I wouldn't really trust this thing to grade a computer on. Like, I wouldn't say it whether or not a computer is good based on this or not. I do like it. It's a cool feature. Let's see. Calculations per second. I got 7.7, out 7.9. Memory operations per second. 7.7, out 7.9. Desktop performance for Windows, which is graphics, 7.1. Gaming graphics, 7.1. And then primary hard disk data transfer rate, which is my SSD, 7.7. So, for the most part, this rating system thing rated this computer extremely, extremely high, which is good, except for the graphics, because my GPU is only a GT 640, which is actually it's a fairly weak card compared to what's out there. It's still a good card, but I am looking forward to upgrading that in the near future to maybe probably a 680 or some equivalent. But yeah, there it is. I just want to show you guys this once it was all done, all built, and now it is. So I did take both panels of the casing off. There they are right there, with the two screws that screw them in. It's just easier to mess around in there when they're both off. Alright, so let's do one more thing real quick. Going to restart it. And then on restart, I'm going to open the BIOS right here, the UEFI BIOS. Then I'm going to go to configuration. And then right here is just some info. $990 FX Extreme 3 motherboard, the AMD 8350, 4000 megahertz, 4 gigahertz. Total memory, like it says, 384 megabytes, so just over 16 gigs. Using a dual channel memory mode. Not gonna mess with that. Right here it tells me my temperatures and stuff. Temperatures are all good, fan speeds are good. Voltage and all that's pretty typical. Nothing to worry about there. All the fans are running, all the lights are on. Let's see. Storage configuration. This is my SSD here, the Corsair 250 6 gig SSD right there. Then go back. Then this is my Seagate 4 terabyte 4000.7 gigs. So that's what the BIOS look like on here. It's pretty simple, pretty nice. I mean, pretty much all UEFI BIOS are gonna have the same features. It's just a different look, different design. So yeah, that's pretty much everything. Optical drive, card readers, then these lights are coming from the cooling fans. There are two fans right in the front, one right there. This is a dock where you can just put SSDs, 2.5-inch SSDs right in there, plug them in like a flash drive. You got your USB ports, audio ports, all that stuff. Adjust the speed of the fans. So, ESATA port, reset button. I can reset it right now. Every now and then I've been experiencing this problem where Windows doesn't start immediately. It goes to this black screen, as you can see right here. And then it takes a while. It will boot. I honestly don't know what's causing this problem. I'm not really worried about it though. I mean, I'll fix it. Try resetting it again. Yeah, so here's the problem. Yeah, so I'm still in the experimental stage, I guess, with this computer. There's going to be some problems. I'm glad to know that that problem that you just witnessed me experience was just software. It was just an operating system problem. Hardware-wise, I'm sure the computer and all the components and all the hardware are just fine. I'll probably end up putting a different, ISO of Windows 7 Ultimate on here, just to see if that makes a difference. It could just be this one has a problem, or it's corrupt or something like that. Or it could just be some settings are getting in the way of booting up. I don't really know. But I'm not worried about it. I'll figure it out. The video is about the hardware, not the software. So, yep. Alright, thanks for watching.